Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. All praises and glorifications are due to Allah, the Sustainer. Blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inshallah, today we will discuss the topic of al-ibtida, bid'ah, innovations. Allah Almighty asks us in the Noble Quran in Surah Ashura, Ba'da a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. أَمْ لَهُمْ شُرَكَاءُ شَرَعُوا لَهُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ مَا لَمْ يَأْذَنْ بِهِ اللَّهِ. Oh, have they partners with Allah, false gods, who have instituted for them a religion which Allah has not ordained? What is bid'ah? هِيَ طَرِيقَةٌ مُخْتَرَأَةٌ يُقْصَدُ بِهَا التَّقَرُّبُ وَالتَّعَبُّدُ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. A newly invented way or belief in Sharia by which nearness to Allah is sought, but not being supported by any authentic proof, neither in its foundations nor in the manner in which it is being performed. In two as-sahihain, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Man ahdatha fi amrina hadha ma laysa minhu fahuwa raddun." Whoever introduces something into this affair of ours, something which does not belong to it, will have it rejected. In another version, man amila amalan laysa alayhi amruna fahuwa raddun. Whoever does an action which we have not commanded will have it rejected. Allah Almighty says in another ayah, ba'da a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ. And indeed, we sent to every nation's messengers to warn them to worship Allah alone and protect themselves from the devil and from associating partners with Allah. Beloved ones in Islam, bid'ah is a precursor to disbelief. Bid'ah is making unfounded statements on behalf of Allah. If one comes up with something new or introduces something new to the fold of Islam, then he or she is indirectly undermining what Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam brought to us from Allah, or is claiming that Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam forgot to tell us or deceived Allah by not totally conveying his message, or simply that he or she knows better than Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Wallahi uqsimu billah, bid'ah is dividing the Muslim nation and making people to abandon the sunnah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam in another hadith said, وَأَحْسَنَ الْهَدِي هَدْيُ مُحَمَّدٍ. The best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad. وَشَرَّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا. In the worst of affairs are the newly invented matters. وَكُلُّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٌ. And for every newly invented matter is an innovation. وَكُلُّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٌ. And every innovation is misguidance. So it is incumbent, oh my dear ones, that we make our ibadah bound and fettered with these three conditions: iman, ikhlas, and ittiba. And be zealous that our worship is in accordance with the sunnah, as those who abandon it are greater than those who cling to it. If not, then scattered dust, scattered dust, scattered dust. Some may ask, what? Why driving a car? Go buy a camel. Did Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wear a watch, nor did he use a computer nor a cell phone? Subhanallah, subhanallah. The answer is exactly no. Imam Shafi, rahimahullah alayhi, said, generally, bid'ah was divided into two types: innovations in worldly matters and innovations in religious matters. Introducing and acting upon a bid'ah in religious matters is a sin and considered one of the enormities in Islam that is obligatory to immediately desist and repent from. Lastly, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, I urge you to adhere to my sunnah and the way of the rightly guided successors who come after me. Hold fast to it and bite onto it with your eye teeth. Until we meet again, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.